Everybody, it's Sandy. I'm in a little bit of a state of panic here, trying to get everything ready, but I am here. We're on the road for the show. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I see somebody looking for popcorn. I think you should pass some my way because I'm hungry. Would like to have a little snack. As you can see, I'm wearing a jacket, a shirt, and a jacket because I got home and it's actually cool. I'm kind of bummed. It's nice outside, but my house is really cool, so I closed the windows. And I thought it was summer because we had hot weather. We had 80s this weekend, and now it's back to being cool. But at least it's sunny, so I guess I'm not going to complain. There you have it. I'm going to get my phone out. It's sitting in my pocket buzzing, but it doesn't look like anything important. Welcome to the show. It is episode, what are we at, 19? We might have to have a party. We didn't decide last week if we were going to have a party at some point. Episode 20 or 25 or something. Figure out what anniversary that is. Silver, gold. You could send me cool stuff. Cool silver and gold stuff. Yeah. Yeah! You could send me stuff. That'd be awesome. Kidding, kidding. Anyway, let's see. The show today, we have our normal features, and I do have a ton of really great hero mail I'm so excited to share with you. I hope you brought your Kleenex, because it's amazing. Let's see. Announcements. We have been sort of working on what the next couple months are going to bring, because Christmas season's coming, so the shippers and I need to turn our brains toward lots of processing of cards, and I want to get all the planning stuff out of the way. So in July, we had our card making party, our virtual card making party. Did you guys enjoy that? How many of you guys came to it? I hope it was lots of you and at least got some of your cards made for the challenges and stuff. I saw lots and lots of folks there, and it looked like there were fantastic cards being made. So that was July. In August, we're going to have a skip, which is one of those short hops. We have a theme planned for it, and we're picking out the bloggers who we know can really tackle that theme and get us inspired on it. So that's going to be in August. September, we have our birthday bash coming. So we want you guys to start planning. We're going to have challenges every day on our blogs. So if you know of a business that wants to offer a challenge on one day or another during the month of September. Last year we had a challenge every single day, so you could get 30 cards made if you just did one for every challenge. And that was pretty cool, and there was lots of candy to give out and everything. And then on our birthday weekend, I think that's the 9th and 10th this year, something like that, in September, we're going to have another of the virtual card making parties. So think about your ideas, because what we had last time, we had bloggers submit their challenge ideas, and then the blog team is the one that will go through those ideas, and we will pick them, and we won't associate them with names, so you know it'll be blind for everybody but me to look at the list and see what the best challenges are. So be thinking about what challenge you might want to offer on your blog, and then you might be one of the 16 chosen for that weekend. Let's see, that's September. Then October, we have World Card Making Day, and that's the first Saturday, I think, in October. I have to double check all that, but we're going to have one of our big hops. It'll be a little modified format, but it'll be another come one, come all hop for World Card Making Day. And in November, we're going to have a skip, and it's going to be a corporate sponsor skip. So I'm going to be trying to drum up some corporate sponsors who want to be part of an 11-11-11 skip with 11 companies. I think that'd be really cool for Veterans Day, especially since Veterans Day is 11-11-11 this year. And then in December, we're going to do a probably another, what did I write down? I wrote down a card making party, and we'll do Valentine's just to get us all out of the Christmas mood for a very short bit during some weekend in December. So that's kind of the plan if you want to be thinking about you know, taking part in our blog hop for World Card Making Day. Have not figured out yet what our theme will be, but we will come up with something fun, and it'll be a good time. So that is those things planned. I wanted to remind everybody, we had a tip that I posted on Facebook yesterday, I think it was, about making sure you fill out your packing slips, because we have lots and lots of new people with us. If there's any new folks with us today on the show, in the audience. Welcome to you. I'm the president. I'm Sandy Alnock, and the president of the organization. And so in addition to that, I wanted to send out another couple of tips, and we're going to be putting out these tips more regularly since we have so many new people. Another tip, in addition to, you know, filling out your thing and counting your cards, because we don't have time to, is to stamp the backs, of course, with your Operation Write Home stamp. You can order one for free on our website. And then put them in an A2 envelope. If you're going to put them in an envelope, put them in an A2 envelope. Because the ones that are a little bit bigger, they're called invitation envelopes. They don't fit in those two rows in our boxes, so they are a shipper's nightmare, because not only do we have to take them out of those and put them in another envelope, then those envelopes go to waste because they're too big. So if it's an A2 card, goes in an A2 envelope. If it's not an A2 card, goes in a bigger envelope. Pretty simple. And I wanted to show you the pile behind me. Do you see that stack of all of these white boxes back here? That is my triage center right now. I put a call out on my Facebook page that I need some help from my local people. And that is how much, I don't know if I can even turn the camera so you can see how tall that is. And you know how tall those stacks of 12 by 12 papers, those racks are. That is how many cards I have that need stamped on the back, tucked. Some of them need full triage because they are they're sample cards from a store, so they have the store's name stamped on the inside, so they all have to be lined as well as stamped and tucked. So there's a lot of work with those. So when we tell you that we would really, really, really love to do to have you tuck your cards, this is the reason why. It has nothing to do really with the cost, because, you know, we get donations and we can cover that cost of the envelopes, but it is the labor. So this is labor I'm going to put some people to work on while I am at CHA. I'm going to hand these boxes out to my locals to line, stamp, and tuck like mad. So they'll all be ready when I get back. Okay, so enough of that. We will be giving out more of those kinds of tips on our Facebook page in coming weeks, days and weeks, because we want everybody to catch up on the rules. Any of you regulars, if you ever see somebody who's a new person on our Facebook page or on our chat box on the homepage or in the forum, please help them. Give them lots of advice and tell them all the general guidelines so that you can assist them in getting to know the ropes around Operation Write Home. It'd be fantastic. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about a little bit before we get started on the rest of the show, gosh, I'm babbling a lot, is CHA. And I'm so excited. Now, for those of you who don't know what CHA is, it is the Craft and Hobby Association. And they have two really big shows every year. They have a bunch of little ones in the middle. Two really big shows, one in Chicago in the summer, and the other, I think, I'm not sure if it's always in the same location. The other one was in California sometimes, Florida sometimes, I don't know. Anyway, Winter Cha. I think it's CHA. I don't think it's Cha. But anyway, I'm going to go to CHA, and many people would you know, give their eye teeth to be able to get into that show because they show off all the new products, which is very cool. But I'm not a product girl. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but, you know, I have enough stuff around here. I don't need more stuff. So what I'm actually looking to do, and I'm very excited about, is getting some partnerships going with some of these companies that we love so very much, and that we see all of their products on the cards that you guys send in. So I have been going through this list of hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of vendors who are going to be at this, and emailing a lot of our regular partners as well, our retail stores, etc., who like to come to CHA to do their purchasing for the year. I have emailed lots of them, and I'm setting up meetings, and we have lunches, and schmooze my little heart out for Operation Write Home, and we have lots of very specific things I want to invite some of them to participate in. And, you know, as those start happening, I will be making you aware of them. Right now, I don't even want to give an idea away because I want to make sure that, you know, these are things that the companies actually want to do. But I have some very, very, if you guys think, excuse me, that I have big sneaky plans every time I come up with some crazy exciting event for you guys, wait till you hear what I have for these companies. They're going to be very excited. And getting some really positive emails back from all these folks who want to meet up with me and talk about Operation Write Home and how to support our heroes who are serving us in harm's way. So anyway, I'm just thrilled to pieces and I can't wait. I'm leaving on the 18th, and I will be back the following Sunday. I'm going to go to the Madison, Wisconsin card making party. So if you're in shouting distance of Madison, Wisconsin, come out on the 23rd. And you can check in on our Facebook wall. I think Barb's been posting pretty regularly about how to contact her or the store if you would like to come, because they're trying to take sign-ups so they know how much stuff to have out. They have a goal of 2,500 cards. 2,500! So if you're able to come and help out with that goal, I know they would love to have you come. And I would love to meet you. So, yes, anybody can come. Sherry was asking if anyone can go. And as long as you can get yourself there, it's an all day, I think 9:30 to 5:30, something like that. So it's an all day venture and should be a blast. Can't wait. I think, is that it for announcements? I'm going to rack my brain. I did not write down any notes today. Sorry about that. Ha! Somebody asked me once, maybe this should be a stuff you want to know segment. How long does it take me to prepare for the show each week? And really it takes the time to turn on Ustream, turn on the camera, turn on the light, and clean off my desk enough that I can see the space. And, you know, sometimes I actually make notes about what to talk about, and other times we just fly by the seat of our pants. So the rest of the show is flying by the seat of our pants. But I have some really cool flying by the seat of our pants stuff that I do have to share with you. So without further ado, okay, and now I hope you brought your Kleenex, because I have some really, really cool hero letters to share with you today. I'm very excited, very, very, very excited. This one is on a card with beautiful painted squares on it. These are, looks like a painted technique, and it's by Ron, the gentleman who did all those cards and is a friend of Michael Strong's. Speaking of which, I need to get back to Michael. He wants to do something with us, and I have not had time to chat with him. Anyway, so this is a thank you card, and it says, "Hello, Sandy. Thank you for your time and support. I'm using the handmade cards already. Congrats to you for getting out that 1,000,000th card. I've noticed when I receive cards, there aren't addresses or return addresses on the backs of all the cards. Is that protocol? The reason I'm asking is because I always love to write back." So those of you who do include your information, he likes to write back. Not everybody does. So if you want to do that, you can, and if you don't want to, that's fine too. We just ask that you don't put a giant label and like a billboard on the back of the card. So just keep it small-ish. Let's see. I feel it's the least that I can do to write back. Plus, I want the people and the persons to know that their hard work and cards have been appreciated. You said that you'll send more cards in about 5 or 6 weeks, but maybe we can space it out to about 8 or 10. There's fewer of us here. Thanks again. From the staff sergeant. So that is one where if you think we have trouble keeping track of all of you guys, we have our heroes to keep track of too. Most of them, we try to keep them on a 5 to 6 week rotation, but then we get a special request like this, or I have a couple units that want cards more often. So I try, if I can, to get them every 3 or 4 weeks and then try to make sure I get them on the right calendar days. So yes, we do have lots of other things to track and follow. Okay, this one. It's from David, and it's on a card made by Ronnie. She has a stamp on the back, and it is a beautiful patriotic thank you card. And it is signed on the inside by a whole bunch of people. You can see lots of signatures there, and I will read those for you. "Thanks for the cards. Thank you for a taste of home. The cards are wonderful. Thank you again for all the support you continue to give. Thank you so much for taking the time and effort to do this. It makes writing home easy and special. The cards are great and mean a lot. Thanks, and looking forward to coming home. This is a great blessing. Thank you for your kind gesture. Thank you so much. This makes writing home so easy. A true blessing. Thanks, FBGA." I don't know if that's his name or his rank or FBGA. Any guesses to what that might be an acronym for? What that might stand for? Anyway. "Thank you. Thank you so much. My family thanks you as well. God bless. Thanks again for the cards. My kids love them." And the captain sent a letter as well. He always writes very nice letters in his. And you see, nice handwriting. How are you? I'm sorry I haven't written in a while. I moved to another base and I just got myself settled in. I was only able to get a few people to sign this card before I left, but the cards went really fast, just like last time. The base I'm at gets OWH cards already, so I should be good for the rest of my tour. I leave here for the US in about 45 days, and I'll be home a couple weeks after that. I can finally look forward to seeing my babies again. And he had three little kids, and he specifically requested superhero cards for one of them, flower cards for his two-year-old little boy, and I can't remember what the third one was. Oh, something with purple for his older daughter. So he finally gets to see his babies. And he says, how is your foot? Are you still shipping as many cards? Tell little David hi for me and let him know that I still have the Noah's Ark card that he made. So he thinks that I know all these children who write the letters. But that was a Noah's Ark card that I actually remembered because it was really, really cute with lots of animal stickers all over it. So that is a letter from David. And this one is from Mara's, let's see, beautiful, lovely, lovely card. Check that out. Very pretty. And she included in it a photo, not very clear, so even showing it to you close up won't help much. Part of our new crew at RCC North in Iraq. So that's their team. Okay, it looks like we froze and we had to restart. So refresh your screen. And see if that will help to restart things. I'm going to try to refresh mine and see. We'll probably all get lovely ads again. Shoot! Sorry about losing the connection there, but I think I've got it back now. Course, just in time for the coolest letter. I'm going to let it sit for a moment and let's see. Okay, so you guys are seeing me back, and so is a commercial. So I'm going to give it a couple seconds before I read this letter because the letter is very cool and you're going to want to hear it. And I want to make sure that there is no ad during that time. So I showed you the card from Yvonne, if I didn't show that already. So it's a card made by Yvonne. It's got her name and everything on the back. And yes, I am recording. So this will be another two-part video. So when they bump me offline, it turns into two pieces. Okay, so this is from the surgeon. And he says, finally, this timely card. I cannot thank you and Operation Right Home enough. The smiles that your boxes bring to the soldiers of the 4th ID headquarters are saved for poets, not physicians like myself. You have made this a family affair. Your daughter, he thinks that Lelaney is my daughter, because I had sent that picture of her and me at the post office. And puppy, take me back to my own home and remind me about what is truly important in this life. Friends, family, and loved ones, thank you for all you do. You are a true patriot. Is that not nice? It's saved for poets, not physicians. The smiles that your boxes bring to the soldiers are saved for poets, not physicians. I mean, that's just so sweet. Oh, sniff, sniff, sniff. That one just came in today and I about lost it when I read that one. And especially because of where he's serving, the base he's serving at, sees a whole lot of really bad stuff. And so for him to have a moment to take to write and say thank you like that was really special. Yes, I will be posting all of these as soon as I get a chance to type them. I don't have time to type them anymore, it seems, but they're in a pile and I will be putting that on the blog. No worries. So that is that. Let me see. Let's do the extreme card makeover, or should we do the Stump Sandy first? What do you guys want to do first? So we can either do the makeover or we can do a stump card. Oh, I see they're running even. Oh, I see somebody double voting. Okay, looks like the stump card is coming first. Don't forget to remind me that we need to look at the extreme card makeover because it's a really cute one this week. Okay, here we go with the stump cards. I have the box in front of me. Those of you who have been here before know how this works. You guys shout out some numbers between 1 and 54. And I will randomly grab a couple numbers. 11, 38, 17. There's a 17. Here is, oh, there is no 11, and I said 38. 738. I see a 52. We don't usually get high numbers, so let's go for one in the back. 52. All right, we shall see what the damage is going to be this time. Let me turn the other camera on so you can watch the joy of opening these lovely envelopes. Does anybody else have like pangs in their heart when the envelopes are going to be open? Because I get nervous just knowing what's going to come. Somebody asked if they could send in ribbon that they don't know how to use, and that would be even more of a challenge because I can't distress it. So I'm not sure that that would be so good. Okay, so we have white paper or polka dots. And okay, this is not looking too bad so far. That's not too awful together. Polka dots and polka dots. Yes, no more hulas. No more hulas. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, Jungo. Okay, we're going to have to go primary, I think. We've got some yellow, red, and blue going on. I'm going to take a quick peek in my box of stamped images, which is emptying out rapidly. I haven't colored anything in ages because I need to refill all my Copics, so I have not been doing a very good job of keeping up on refilling the box with new stuff. Let's see, we have a bunny that would work. Not really. Yikes, this is going to be interesting. Very, very interesting. We have some birds. It's purple, that won't work. That could work. This little girl could work. She's kind of cute. Because I think, you know, we're going to have to use some colors as accents somehow. We have a cardinal. We have random kitty cats, which, you know, you can always do random kitty cats with pretty much anything. And that looks like about it for stuff that will go specifically with these papers, I do believe. So, do we have any votes or opinions on what it should be that goes with these papers? I'm not looking. I know I'm not looking. Okay, bees, 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 bees. Oh, I think I see a few bees there. Anybody else want bees? Because I see lots of people talking bees. Ay, ay, ay. And yes, somebody asked the question how I get all these envelopes. And yes, they are sent to me by folks. You send them in a single sheet. And I'm getting texts with bees. You send a single sheet in an envelope, just one at a time. And then I will be able to pull out yours. And then what I do is, as I use up numbers and I get new ones, I fill them in so that we just have a one through whatever typically to choose from. Okay, so we're going to do the bees. And, oops, look, something stuck to the bees. There's birds stuck to the bees. Oh, isn't that funny? Birds and the bees. Ha, ha, ha. I am a riot, are I not? Okay. Turn blue over. No, I think I'm not going to turn the blue over. I think I'm going to use the blue as an accent because I think it could use a little punch, and that will somehow be the punch. It might not be much of that blue, but I think it's really still a cool color. I kind of like it. Okay, so we're going to go bees, and I think I had said something at one point about potentially using some nesties to show you something. And I think I'm going to do it on this one because I can make I'm going to show you how you can do this kind of a thing, and you can have those flowers pop out of the circle. I don't know if you guys have seen that before or not, but I'm going to do that here for you right now. So you get your nesty. This is a nestability. It's a die, for those who don't know what nestabilities are. And you'll place it where you're going to want the thing to be. And you can draw a little pencil line in there, but I don't have any erasers handy, so I'm not going to do that. But I am going to mark where the flower goes. What I'm going to do is cut just up to the flower and a little bit in, just so I have enough of it, and you'll see why in just a moment. Because I need that flower to stick out just a little, because I'm going to run it through the die cutter like this. And that way the die is going to cut the circle, but it's going to leave that flower intact. And then I can trim it up nicer later. Can you see that? So you cut whatever piece it is, just cut some slits in the paper, and then let that be sort of a tab hanging out. Tuck your nestability underneath of it, and then place it where you want it. And I'm going to run it through. I can't fit the cuddle bug underneath of the camera here, but hopefully if you don't know what a cuddle bug is and you don't know how nestabilities work, you can find a tutorial on YouTube. Let me get my plates here so that I can cut this. So I'm going to put my little bees in here. Okay, so now the piece that I have looks like this. So it has the flower sticking out. So now all I have left to do, and I could have cut this part off before, but it just seems like it'll be easier when there's less paper hanging around. Now I can cut out that flower so that it sticks out of my circle. Now the tutorial that I saw said that you should draw a pencil line in there and cut up to your pencil line. Now some stamps, depending on what they are, you may find that that's going to help you. But on one like this, where it's literally just a flower that's hanging out, voila, there we go. Now if I make a scallop out of this blue, I'm going to try to do a round scallop, which will even highlight further the fact that this little guy is sticking out from the circle. So what I'm going to do, and I will show you why, I'm going to center this as much as possible, because I'm going to use the inside piece for my scallop, and I'm going to use the outside piece for a layer. So for those who like to save paper and get as much use out of every sheet as possible, I do this a lot. Whenever I'm punching things out, I make sure I cut in as far as I can so that I can use that outside piece for a layer. So this I can stick on here. My trusty OWHtv gun. I'm going to center this so our little bees are surrounded by blue. Now if I want to have, I think I'm going to have this be the background paper. So I need to get my cuddle bug moved. If you're wondering what's off to the side here that I use as my little table, it's actually a very small bar stool. So it's kind of not the best option for things like this, but there you have it. I need to get myself a nice little side table. So now I can glue this on here. I'm going to cut a little bit more off that side. I can glue this on, and you don't even know that there's a big hole underneath of it. So I'm getting double use out of that blue paper. So Well, I hear some people, or see some people chatting. I hope you guys are having a wonderful, wonderful discussion there of something. I don't know if there's some exciting things going on in chat. If you're watching this show later, you're missing lots of crazy fun. Whenever I start seeing exclamation points and things, I always know that the ladies are having fun in chat. So, that is where we are so far on this card. And I'm going to cut this down a little farther. And I want to use just the polka dotted portions. I don't really want to go for the pink flowers quite so much. So I'm going to layer this underneath here to add just a little bit more separation. But that is bothering me because there's not nearly enough contrast. So I'm going to take somewhere here, I have some plain navy blue, and I'm going to layer just a little bit more. But I'm going to round those bottom corners. When I do scallop nesties, for some reason I obsessively seem to need rounded corners somewhere on the card because they're so rounded and soft themselves that they need a little bit of roundness on the card. So I'm adding just a very, very thin edge around this blue, or around of the blue around the polka dotted paper. And then I'm going to punch those corners. So that's going to go here. And I'm going to hope I have some really cool ribbon in my stash that's going to go around this card, because I think ribbon right around that will be a lot of fun around the bottom of the card. So let's see what we have. Either some yellow or some blue and yellow. I don't know if I have any blue and yellow. Dun, 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 dun. I think I have some navy blue. And I have... don't know if I'll use a little bit of yellow or not. Let me put the blue on there and see what I think about the rest of it. Because that blue is going to start pulling things together. It adds a little bit of a punch. And of course, since we have that big hole in there, all of my glue is sticking to everything. And I noticed one of you guys was telling someone else on Facebook that I never wrap my ribbon all the way around the card. I do on occasion, but typically I try to do this because it will save me ribbon in the long run. And... the trusty dimensional adhesive here. I'm going to have to do a poll and see how many of you guys have switched to using this dimensional adhesive since the show, because I would like to tell the manufacturer of this how many people are now, because of OWH, using this very cool dimensional adhesive. This stuff, for anybody who doesn't know it, is thinner than some of the little square stuff, so it's actually pretty cool. So there is the bees, and now I want to add a bow to this, so my other piece of blue ribbon can now go around here and tie a very simple ribbon on it. I could have done a fork bow, and I didn't, because I still have not gone out and gotten myself a giant fork to do it with. I tried the technique with a little fork, and it really didn't work so well, or else I'm just a klutz. Not sure which. So, there's my little bow. Ta-da-da-da! So there's that, and I think I have, looky there, some blue cardstock to use for the card base. Well, actually, maybe since this is a full size, well, maybe this is not big enough. Maybe that, that's not a full 4 1/4 by, oh. Well, it's 4 1/4 by 5 3/4 for some weird reason. Not sure why that is, but we can cut that off after I get it adhered on here. If you need a tutorial on how to tie a bow, do a search on our blog for fork bow, because there is a very cool tutorial on how to cut, how to tie a bow by using a fork, which is pretty slick, I would have to say. I think that was probably our most popular tutorial so far, maybe aside from the pinwheels that actually have made cards, but got the most oohs and ahs from people. So, need to cut that down a little bit thinner. I have ready-made liners that are in my little drawer prepared for me and donated by someone. So on this one, since there's a bee on the front, I'm going to put a sentiment on the inside. And I have Be Happy, and this is a red rubber stamp, or not a red rubber stamp, a gray rubber stamp. Used to be on wood, and is now not on wood, of course, as you can see. It's just got yucky stuff on the back. And I use this stuff called Tack and Peel. It's sticky on the front of my block, and the back is not sticky, but your stamps can then stick to that. You can use acrylics on them, but it's a little bit over sticky when it's new, so it's a little challenge to use. But this stuff just washes off, and then it becomes re-stickified. If you've ever had those clings that kids use in bathtubs and things, and when they get wet, they get sticky again, that's kind of the stuff that this is made out of. And it saves me from having to mount everything. So I'm going to put the stamp in the corner so that there is plenty of room for our hero to write around it. And even with that, I'm going to take a tiny bit of a yellow marker, and I'm just going to give the bee a little bit of color. Ba-dum. Stump Sandy for the day! Dun, 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 dun. Now maybe there could be a little sentiment up there. I'm not really sure if it needs one, but I think it's really cute, just as it is. I think it's just a little simpler is okay by me. So there is our Stump Sandy. If you wanted to see it any closer than that. Okay, so my favorite Copic yellow, Y17. It's the same color as my car. It's my favorite yellow in the world. Best in the universe. So, I wanted to show you my very cute little, I know what I'm going to do next. We're going to have a commercial break. And I hope this is not the one I showed last week. I can't remember if I actually got around to showing it or if I forgot. But here you go.
President Obama could start bringing troops back home from Afghanistan within weeks.
In the meantime, local military families and volunteers are letting troops know they are not forgotten. Jeff Van Sant has the story.
Thank you for serving our country. Thank you so much for helping us be safe. Love, Hannah.
Through letters and homemade cards, volunteers help to bring a little piece of home to military personnel stationed all over the world.
There is email and Skype and Facebook and all that, but there's nothing like the homemade touch of a card and a handwritten note.
Sonia Leong is a Marine Corps wife. Her husband is in Afghanistan.
It's so easy to forget after being at war for such a long time that there are still troops that are out there and that are away from their homes and families and loved ones. For all of these volunteers to be here today is just a great outpouring of support.
These volunteers are part of a nationwide effort. More than 1 million cards have been shipped.
This is just one way that I know that we can stay connected.
For soldiers, it's a comfort while deployed.
When we opened up the box, I immediately shared it with the rest of the team and had all the guys take 10 cards and send them home immediately.
In just one day's work, these volunteers helped to make more than 3,000 cards, and these will be shipped off this week. Jeff Van Sant, Q13, Fox News.
There are more than 8,000 volunteers nationwide. Local organizers say the event continues to grow every year.
So that was another of our news pieces. Very exciting. I'm still waiting. They're supposed to get me a better copy of it because that video skips right when it says Operation Ride Home. And I know that was not intentional, but boy, that was just not a pleasant accident. So yes, that was our card making party we had here in Washington. And I was very excited to have that reporter come out and do that story. And I'll be showing the other ones as we get the videos. I can't remember if I showed one of the ones from Philly last week or not, but I'll have to go back and look and see if I did, because I want to make sure I get that in the show too. And we have another story from Philly with same gal, Colleen. And that was the one that I Skyped in on. And then there was one from Virginia. So I'm going to be purchasing that one too. We'll put them all on our YouTube. If I end up putting the new copy of this one onto our YouTube, I'm going to ask that you guys go and watch it again all the way to the end, because it doesn't count until you watch until YouTube turns it off. But I want to get the hit count back up on it once we repost it. So, yay! Okay, so next is the Extreme Card Makeover that I have made for you this week. So I was looking for some sort of a card. Sorry, my bangs are bugging me. I think I need to get them trimmed. I was looking for a card that I could use as a really simple one, because I'm going to take some card kits with me when I go to Madison, Wisconsin, but I'm going to be taking them on the plane. And so I want them to be really flat. I don't want to need a lot of tools. I don't want to need a lot of stuff. So I just want to be able to take a chunk of paper. And so this is one of the ideas I came up with. And you'll see the evolution of it, because it started off as the first card, which would be perfectly acceptable, and then moved into what the third card will be. And I think it's much cuter. And it's also based on something we had in the virtual card making party this weekend. So turn the camera on. Now this is a stamp set by Stampin' Up! That I was using. And I just think it's just such a cute little one. Sending warm wishes on your bug day. So I was just going to do some really cute, simple, layered paper. That was it. So I thought, oh yeah, that'll be really easy. I'll just have a whole bunch of stamped images ready to roll. We just glue them together. But I thought, you know, that's not very exciting. So I took it another level and I put it on a black, it's on a white base, but a black layer in the background. And I did three little worms in a row, oops, sorry, with the sentiment stamped on the side. And then I added a birthday hat and googly eyes. And I thought it would be really fun. I think this is the version I'm going to use, because it'll be really fun to just add googly eyes and hats out of whatever scraps we have to these. And I think that would be really cute. And it'll be really easy to get stamped and ready for the card making party and have bunches of kits. And the third one is based on, it's a little tricked out, and it's based on something that you'll recognize from the hop. And this was the fishbowl that gave me this idea. I think it was Julie Fountain who had done her card was shaped like a fishbowl. So I did it shaped kind of like a terrarium. I remember when I was a kid putting lots of bugs and things into a little terrarium and keeping them, and caterpillars and all sorts of stuff. So now the caterpillars are in a shaped card. So all I had to do was round the corners at the bottom. And I made a ding in the corners here. And actually, I did it on the white shape first. I cut the whole thing and rounded both the top corners and the bottom corners, I cut it here, so there's a slice you can't see underneath it there. And I took the slice off of one end and I stuck it on the other, or actually I took this and I just flipped it upside down so it went out, if that makes sense. I might have to do a little drawing to show you how that worked. But it made a really cute little jar, and then I just put a ribbon around it. And then when I mounted it onto the cardstock, I just trimmed the cardstock to match that. And I still have to put a shaped layer in it because now I can't do just a regular rectangle. But anyway, it was just a lot of fun to make this one. I used some scissors that have, let me see if I can find them. And even though I said I'm not a product girl, this was something that I found myself, quote unquote, needing to buy when I saw them. And of course, I don't know what I did with them. There's some Martha Stewart scissors. I've used them all of 2 times now, but they have a whole bunch of, where are they? Oh, I'll have to show them to you another time. But they have a whole bunch of tines in them, so they cut multiple pieces of, yes, the fringe scissors. They cut multiple pieces at the same time. So that's what I used on those. And then all the little guys are popped for a little bit of dimension. So that's my tricked out extreme makeover card, which was just really cute to put little bugs in there. So anyway, so this is the one I think I'm going to use for the kit. I'll have the stamping done, and a bag of googly eyes and some pearl pen that we can use on the tips of the hats. And people can decorate up the little worms. They can make balloons for them if they want, whatever we want to add to them. But I think that'll be a nice simple card, and it'll be a little cute happy birthday card. So that is the extreme card makeover for this week. Pretty fun little worms. And I might even try some other things with other ones of the bugs in that set, because it's a really cute set. It's got really fun little critters wherever they are. And I was going to get them out too, but I didn't do that because I apparently don't have them handy. I was going to show you the set. Oh well. Never mind. Another day, another time. So there you have it, our show for the week. We have 10 more minutes left, looks like, 18 after. And so if you would like, we can either take some questions from the Peanut Gallery, or I can read some kids' mail. So I do have some kids' letters, if you guys want to hear some of those. Sorry about all these ads. One of the requests I'm going to make from our vendors that I'm going to be meeting is to have them sponsor the show, so they can show, we can show off some of their product, and they will pay the fee for membership to this thing, so that we can actually get rid of the ads, which would be nice, very nice thing. I see kids mail and seeing cards from the box. I don't want to show the ones that are in those boxes because I don't want to embarrass anyone that their cards are sitting in the triage. Sorry. I don't like to out them that they didn't include envelopes, because some of them do feel badly about it because they can't afford envelopes, and we don't mind that at all, but I don't want to really show those. So let me grab some kids' mail, and we will while away a few moments with that in the meantime. Because I always have some little kids' mail here. How is the painted card from the mailbag done? That I don't know. Maybe I'll have to ask Ron if he'll show us. It was probably just various types of pet paints and inks, and then he painted a sheet and then cut them into squares and then arranged the squares. That's what it looks like. Okay. Dear Hero, my name is Andrew and I'm in the first grade. I like to learn about jets in school. What was your favorite subject in school? My favorite color is brown. You are a hero because you fight for our country. Sincerely, Andrew. And Andrew drew a fabulous picture with a tree and a sunshine. He's got lots of branches in his tree and a big hill with grass on it. And I'm not really sure what's going on there, but a little person thinking about something. Yeah, is that bicycles maybe? Or no, maybe that's bicycles. That could be. Well, it's bicycles or motorcycles. So let's see. Here's one from Kevin. Dear hero, you are very brave and you make our country a better place. I hope you're safe there. And Kevin drew a picture as well for his on his Any Hero letter. He colored all the backgrounds so nicely, which was fantastic. We have one from Megan. It says, Dear military trooper, I am a 15-year-old girl in high school living currently in Nevada. I play the flute in our high school band. I love to draw. I'm an art student. So I just wanted to say hi and thank you for providing protection for our country. Many people face difficult challenges, but others face even harder ones. Thank you again for protecting this country. Yours truly, Megan. In God we trust. And she drew this stunning, stunning eagle. How cool is that? An eagle carrying a flag. Isn't that beautiful? I'm just so impressed with the kids who write hero mail and draw pictures and color pictures and stuff. Because I think they're way cool. And here's another well-colored one, and it just has a short note that says, thank you for helping the USA. But it has the most rainbowy eagle I have ever seen. How is that for fun? I can squish that in there so you can see it. Really, really bright, bright one. Very, very cute. And then this one is very, very darling. I love the fact that she decorated the envelope. And she, on the outside of her envelope, says, guess who misses you? And she has googly eyes on it. And on the back it says, from Anna, age 7.5. And inside it is her card that has stickers all over it and says, you are a hero. She's got lots more stickers. Lots more stickers. And she even drew some paw prints. I bet you she likes dogs. Very, very cute. Oh, Dixie just texted me a picture of the scissors because she apparently has a pair. But I don't know if I can get that onto the screen in time. But maybe I can post that when I post the video. I will post Dixie's picture of those scissors, which will be awesome, so you can see what they are for those who don't know yet. Okay, 7:23, we still have a couple more minutes. Hello, my name is April. Thank you for protecting America. If you do not help America, then many people could die. Of course, I can't stay in America. Keep protecting America. Thank you so much. If I'm a soldier, I would be very afraid, so would run away. But you stay in the war and help people, so very much thank you. If you have time, protect Korea too, because I'm Korean. No, I mean protect America. And if you have time, you protect Korea. Thank you so much. From April. So, very cute. She wants to make sure that both Korea and America are protected and very safe. Dear hero, I hope you help all the people in California and the people in the Army. Thank you for protecting our Earth and your Army for helping all the people. Your friend, Nicole, in the third grade, and she colored a dog. I think the dogs are one of the most popular ones. I don't know if the East Coasters and everybody else find the same thing. But we find certain coloring pages appeal to certain groups and certain ages and stuff. So here's another one. Dear soldier, I'm very thankful to have you defending our country. I, too, am planning on joining our military, Naval Explosive Ordnance Disposal, EOD, and I greatly respect your decision and dedication to our country. This is from Nathaniel. And Nathaniel drew out the insignias of the branches. How cool is that? He's got the Marine Corps here, and looks like he didn't finish these two. So we have the Coast Guard, this is the Department of the Navy, the Army, and the Air Force. So he's got all the branches there. He must have had a textbook he was copying them out of, so that was pretty fancy. You want to see the amount of detail in those. You can see the Army one there with the big eagle. And here he drew all of the detail. Isn't that nice? Somebody's going to think that's really, really impressive. And he wrote this nice letter, and he's going to do EOD. That's what he thinks. Like, wowzer, wowzers. Here's another fun colored one, and it's from Quentin, and it doesn't have a note on it except for the thank you hero colored at the top, but it has a smiley face and it has just coloring everywhere, and he apparently had a lot of fun. He likes yellow just like me. Very cute. And he wrote "From Quentin" on the bottom. Pretty exciting coloring he's got going there. And let's see what else we've got here. Just going to pick out some different types of stuff. Here we have another Sierra that says, "Thank you for all you do for us." And it's from Eric. And Sierra is all colored with rainbow colors too, which is very fun. Do shippers read Adult Hero Mail too? Yes, we do. There's actually some Adult Hero Mail that got us concerned in the first place because we had some political opinions that were shared and stuff in some of the Hero Mail. So we read it all. That's why we ask not to seal it, so we can do that. Okay, we're going to read one more, but it's a really long one. I'm going to see if maybe I can figure out how to do it quickly. Dear Hero, thank you for fighting for the country we live in. It's hard to fathom what you've been through since joining the military. My life seems so normal, safe, and probably boring compared to yours. But I have to thank you for letting me live my normal life and keeping me safe. My name is Lorraine. I'm a senior at Newark Memorial High School in California. I'm basically the baby of the family because I'm the last sibling to go to college. My mom always tells me the house is going to be way more calm and quiet without me there. I think I'm going to go across the country for college, University of Pennsylvania, Columbia, NYU, BC, or Georgetown. I want to play volleyball wherever I go, maybe not varsity, but intramural. I'm in my school's starting outside hitter. I'm only 5'5", but I've got some hops. Not sure what that means. Do you play a lot of sports in the military? Do you guys play a lot of football? That seems like a pretty manly sort of sport. Do you play volleyball there? My boyfriend plays football, wrestles, and pole vaults. Talk about a jock, right? I'm kidding. He's little, 5'7" to 8", 140 pounds, blonde, who plays cornerback and wide receiver. He always looks like the smallest on the field. Maybe write me back, and has the school's address on it. So, as you can see, some people write really long ones, and some people write really short ones, and they're all okay to send. We just love to have lots and lots of letters to send from all across the country because those mean so very much to people. There were recently a couple of boxes that I had to send with no Hero Mail in them, but I sent them their first box with no Hero Mail, knowing that they wouldn't miss it because they hadn't gotten it before. So in the second box, they actually were like, "Wow, this Hero Mail is amazing," because they hadn't gotten it the first time. So that really showed me that we need to make sure there's Hero Mail in every box, even if I have to sit and write my little hand off. So please do continue writing lots of Hero Mail and getting those to your shippers, because we need those. The more cards, the more boxes of cards we send, the more Hero Mail we need. So in proportion with the cards growing, the Hero Mail also needs to grow. So if you know schools or groups or churches or workplaces or anything where you can ask for people to sign Hero Mail, that'd be great if you could do that. So I'm going to stick around for a couple minutes after the show to do a little after party and answer some questions, but I do have a whole bunch of stuff to do. I've got a lot of emails to send for CHA, try to make some more connections, and I have to start getting prepared to sort all of that stuff and giving it to different people and figuring out what's in those so I can give them to the appropriate persons to do their duty on them. So I think that's it for today. We're going to have a show next week. The following week, I'm going to be at CHA, so I probably will not have a show that Thursday night, but we are going to try to have some other sessions. It might be weird random times, not really sure what the schedule is going to be, but we'll see what we can do. I'm going to do some video recording while I'm at CHA and post some of those videos on either YouTube or Facebook, depending on what I have time to do and whether I have time to process it as an actual video or if it's just going to be just a plain old clip of something. So hopefully that will be a lot of fun and you guys are going to kind of get to virtually go along on the tour of CHA with me. So that'll be a lot of fun. That's it. It's 7:30. It is time to sign off from the show, from the recording. But as I said, hang around a minute and I will be back with just a couple minutes to answer some questions. Talk to you soon. Keep those cards and letters coming.